नमस्कार, राष्ट्रीय शिक्षा माध्यमिक शिक्षा अभियान एंड आईआईटी बॉम्बे क्वालिटी इम्प्रूवमेंट इन मैथ एजुकेशन। माय नेम इज़ मुल्लानी शाहजान रसूल सो। माय रजिस्ट्रेशन नंबर इज़ MTE196। माय स्कूल नेम इज़ जवाहर विद्यालय गोरंबे, तालुका कागल। माय डिस्ट्रिक्ट नेम इज़ कोल्हापुर। माय टॉपिक नेम इज़ lines and angles. I thankful to Mr. Rana sir and Gharpure sir and his all colleagues. This video based PPT includes three steps: observe and explore, define and prove, and apply and evaluate. First step is observe and explore. To see this video and images,
all of you have the idea of lines, parallel lines and angles. If you look around yourself in your surroundings, you will see enormous use of lines and angles. The best example is your home. Have a look. The corners of walls of the room are straight lines perpendicular to the lines at the bottom, thus making an angle of 90 degrees. The roof of the room has two pairs of parallel lines. In fact, the roofs of a home are made using iron rods, which are arranged in the form of parallel lines, horizontally and vertically, to give strength to the roof. Now have a look at this house. These types of houses have slant roofs, that is, the roofs are inclined at an angle with each other to prevent water from getting stagnant and piling of snow. One other example is the railway tracks. The tracks are made of parallel iron rods to prevent derailment.
Points on the same line are called collinear points. Line segment. A line segment is a part of a line which has two distinct endpoints. We can also say that it is a link between two points. Angle. Two rays joined with a common endpoint form an angle. The common endpoint is called a vertex. Complementary angles. When the sum of the measures of two angles is 90 degrees, the angles are called complementary angles. Supplementary angles. When the sum of the measures of two angles is 180, the angles are called supplementary angles. Adjacent angles. Adjacent angles have a common vertex and a common arm but no common interior points. Examples are as shown below. Linear pair. A linear pair is a pair of adjacent angles whose non-common sides are opposite rays. Vertically opposite angles. When two lines intersect, the vertically opposite angles so formed are equal. Intersecting lines. When two lines meet at a point, they are called intersecting lines. The common point is called point of intersection. Example: the letter Y made up of line segments. This is an example of intersecting lines. Angles made by a transversal. A line that intersects two or more lines at distinct points is called a transversal.
Here some examples of parallel lines. Parallel parking. Opposite sides of windows. Here transversal and parallel lines. Railway track. Parallel lines are seen. Here some angles, images of angles. Intersecting lines. Line T is transversal. Line T is intersect two lines A and B. Here line OH is transversal of line MA and line ZE. What you have seen here? You have seen here lines, parallel lines, transversal, angles, intersecting lines. Transversal definition: a line that intersects two lines at different points is called as transversal. Line T is transversal. Opposite angles, two angles that are opposite angles. Opposite angles are congruent. Supplementary angles, two angles that form a line, their sum is 180 degree. Here pairs of supplementary angles. Corresponding angles, two angles that occupy corresponding positions. Top of two lines and left two transversal are corresponding angles. Top of two lines and right two transversal are corresponding angles. Bottom two lines and left two transversal are corresponding angles. Bottom two lines and right two transversal are also corresponding angles. Here corresponding pairs of corresponding angles are shown. Alternate interior angles. Two angles that lie between parallel lines on opposite sides of the transversal. Angle 3 congruent angle 6, angle 4 congruent angle 5. Alternate exterior angles, two angles that lie outside parallel lines on opposite sides of the transversal. Angle 2 congruent angle 7, angle 1 congruent angle 8. Consecutive interior angles, two angles that lie between parallel lines on the same sides of the transversal. Interior angles are supplementary angles. Angle 3 plus angle 5 equal to 180 degree. Angle 4 plus angle 6 equal to 180 degree. Now, define and prove. Here, we can prove that the sum of measures of all angles of a triangle is 180 degree. Theorem is the sum of measures of all angles of a triangle is 180 degree. This theorem depends upon properties of parallel lines and angles. Given triangle ABC is any triangle. To prove angle ABC plus angle ACB plus angle BAC equal to 180 degree. Here we have to construction, draw a line parallel to segment BC and passing through A. On the line, points P and Q such that P dash A dash Q. Prove line PQ parallel line BC and segment AB is transversal is given. Therefore, angle ABC equal to angle PAB, that is alternate angles, equation 1. Line PQ parallel line BC and segment AC is a transversal as a given. Therefore, angle ACB equal to angle QAC, alternate angles, second equation. Therefore, from first and second equation, angle ABC plus angle ACB equal to angle PAB plus angle QAC, that is equation 3. Adding angle BAC to both sides of equation 3, we get angle ABC plus angle ACB plus angle BAC equal to angle PAB plus angle QAC plus angle BAC equal to angle PAB plus angle BAC plus angle QAC equal to angle PAC plus angle QAC, because angle PAB plus angle BAC equal to angle PAC equal to 180 degree, because angles in linear pair, that is sum of measures of all three angles of a triangle is 180 degree. Examples up on theorem. First example is in triangle ABC, angle A equal to 65 degree, angle C equal to 45 degree, then find the value of angle B. Solution: angle A plus angle B plus angle C equal to 180 degree. The sum of measures angles of a triangle is 180 degree. Angle A is equal to 65 plus angle B plus angle C equal to 45 degree equal to 180 degree. Therefore, angle B equal to 180 minus 110. Therefore, angle B equal to 70 degree. Second example is in triangle ABC, angle A equal to 120 degree, angle B equal to 34 degree. Find the value of angle C. We know that the sum of measures of angles of a triangle is 180 degree. Therefore, angle A plus angle B plus angle C equal to 180 degree. The sum of measures angles of triangle is 180 degree. Angle A is 120 plus angle B is 34 degree plus angle C equal to 180 degree. 120 plus 34 is 154 degree. Therefore, angle C equal to 180 minus 154. Therefore, angle C is 26 degree. Third example is, in right angled triangle BCA, angle A is x degree, angle B is 2x degree, angle C is 90 degree. Find the value of x and also find value of angle A, angle B. In triangle ABC, angle A plus angle B plus angle C equal to 180 degree. The sum of measures angles of a triangle is 180 degree. Angle A is x degree plus angle B is 2x degree plus angle C is 90 degree, therefore equal to 180 degree. Therefore, 3x equal to 180 minus 90. Therefore, 3x equal to 90. Therefore, x equal to 90 upon 3. Therefore, x equal to 30. Therefore, angle A equal to x equal to 30 degree. Angle B equal to 2x equal to 60 degree. Now, third step is apply and evaluate. For this, first example is prove that sum of angles of quadrilateral is 360 degree. Triangle PQR, angle PRS is exterior angle. Prove that angle PRS equal to angle PQR plus angle QPR. Second example is, in figure, line P parallel line Q and transversal lines are line L and line M. Measures of some angles are shown in the figure. Hence, find the measures of angle A, angle B, angle C, angle D. Second example is, in triangle ABC, angle A equal to 3x plus 28 degree, angle B equal to 5x plus 52 degree, angle C equal to 2x minus 10 degree. Then find the value of x. Hence, find measure of all angles.